What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Umthar Gaming Channel. I am AJ Gels. Guys, we're here with episode 5 of Game of Thrones, the Cersei Lannister quote. When you play the Game of Thrones, you win or you die. Those are some big stakes right there. I'd choose not to play. I'm just gonna kind of talk in this little opening here while it loads to do the previously on. Last video was really short. You know, I was finishing up the previous episode 4, and that's kind of what happened last time. It was one scene with Roderick returning from White Hill, and not really sure where we're gonna pick up. We might pick up with Asher, or we might pick up exactly where we left off with Roderick. This is episode 5, A Nest of Vipers. So, I hate this opening load screen every time. There we go.
Previously on Game of Thrones. You'd help the Second Sons, guide them into Meereen.
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Get them into the city, help them liberate Meereen, and I will see that you are rewarded.
You think you can reason with a war, Whitling?
No, I'm a friend.
Don't move.
This is my sister, Sylvie.
I have to get in there, Sarah. Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family, and someone in there is helping him.
Andros is hiring sellswords, hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath.
Talia, I may be leaving you here with a traitor.
Find out who it is.
I don't remember saying that.
Rodri!
That's like a dog.
Can't be broken. I've decided to come see for myself. I was just telling your sister. Father's been looking to make a match for me, and Talia's been such good company. Think she likes me? Or maybe your mother? A flower plucked is still a flower. Just dies more quickly.
We could be a family, Lord Forrester. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
You'll never marry either of them.
Never's such an awfully long time. But let's put our happy day to the side for a moment. Walk with me. Oh, you won't need your sword. Not where we're going.
I'm not going without my sword.
I'm afraid you are. Here, I'll help you. There. Doesn't that feel better? Oh, you're coming too.
This is Lord's business, not a child's.
I say she comes. I don't trust her with my men.
I mean, at least we still have a cane. Sorry.
How fares your father, Lord Bolton?
Better than yours.
Polite of you to ask.
Asshole.
I loved playing in the woods when I was your age. Still do? So many places to hide. I've gotten very good at finding people.
Roderick?
It's all right, Talia.
That reminds me. Where's Griff? I expected to be greeted by him on my arrival. Bit of a disappointment to have to show myself in.
And here I had such high hopes for Ludson.
Griff was injured. The Maester is looking after him.
I'm aware of Griff's injuries, and that you inflicted them. Oh, I really hoped things might be different with you. I hoped we could be friends. After all, I was generous. I've allowed you to keep half your forest. Your livelihood. Yet you went behind my back and called in the Glenmores. I'm not sure how you managed that. The Glenmores have sworn their loyalty to my father.
Lady Elena Glenmore is our guest. The soldiers accompanied her to ensure her safety.
If her safety is a concern, perhaps she should not have come to Ironwrath. Well, I'm certainly glad we've sorted this out. Thank you for being so forthcoming. But there's still a price. Ah. Here we are.
That's what I thought.
Roderick!
You disobeyed me. You disrespected me. Someone has to pay! You didn't think it would be you, did you? Your damaged goods. Someone else's leftovers.
Arthur's done nothing wrong! If you want to hurt someone, hurt me!
No, Roderick!
Why bother? You're nearly a corpse already.
Stop!
Look at what you've done! I hope it was worth it.
Is it worth it, Arthur?
Oh, shit.
Please!
Talia, don't look away.
No!
It's very important you see what comes of disobedience.
Roderick, make him stop!
Talia, don't look.
Please.
Look at him, Talia. See what your brother's done.
Please, Lord Ramsay.
Sorry, but they'll never learn otherwise.
Mercy, have mercy! Mercy, my lord!
Did Roderick show mercy to Griff? This is his fault.
I did show mercy to him. That's why he's not dead.
That's a lot of blood.
I'll see you dead for this!
And that, Talia, is why no one likes your brother. Ah, the poor lad's fainted. Let's give him a minute. You want to kill me, don't you?
Damn straight I do.
Release him. Go on. Prove how strong you are. Do it for Ethan.
No, Roderick. He's toying with you.
Do it. Come on, Roderick.
It's not the smart play.
Your little brother had bigger balls than you. I came here to kill you, but now I realize it might be far more entertaining to watch Lud tear you to pieces. I never want to come back to this fucking shit stain of a holdfast. I have better things to do than to play wet nurse to you and Lud. So you'll settle this on your own. Last house standing wins. Otherwise, I'll kill you both and be done with it.
House Forrester will win this fight.
You're very confident for a man with no army and half a face. And one more thing.
Oh, Jeez, how do you do that with that small of a knife?
Ready the horses. Not sure you'll have much luck finding other allies.
There's no way that knife could have cut that deep to open his stomach like that. Or that easily. Huh.
Only a monster would do such a thing. The Boltons will pay for this. Arthur. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Keep asking myself what we've done to deserve such hate. Did we bring it on ourselves? Or is this house just cursed?
This is my fault. If I hadn't agreed to Elena's plan...
You didn't do this, my lord. Blame Ramsay, blame Lud, blame the gods if you have to. But don't blame yourself. The Glenmore Guard are gone. Ordered home by Ramsay. So much for having allies.
Ramsay says he's not taking sides anymore. He means to let the strongest house survive. I intend that to be us, Duncan.
But can we even fight them? We don't have the numbers. We don't yet have Ryan back. And if Mira's right about an army from the south...
We'll worry about that after we get Ryan back. Once we've made the trade, then we can start discussing.
Where is he? Where is my brother?
My lady. My lady.
Let me through!
Elena.
Roderick! Tell me where he... Oh! No! No! Oh, no! No! Arthur, no! Arthur! It's my fault. I brought him into this. I asked him to help.
You can't blame yourself, Elena. He was a grown man. He made his own choices.
But he trusted me. He always has. I was there the day he learned to hold a bow. He was so nervous, the father called him Quiver. And now to die, like this, tortured.
Ramsay Snow did this. He's a madman.
Ramsay was here because of you, Roderick. If we hadn't been your allies...
Elena.
I'm sorry.
Get you someplace warm.
How do I do this, Roderick? How do I keep going? Where do I find the strength?
Know that we'll have our justice someday.
Justice won't bring my brother back. You've been such a friend to me, Roderick. Right from the very beginning. I should try to get some sleep. I'm not sure I'll be able to.
You're not alone, Elena. I'm here for you.
whatever you need.
Thank you, Roderick. Ah, there you are. I haven't seen you since the coronation feast. How many ships do you suppose it takes to move an army? Ships? Why in the world would you... Never mind. Mira, I'll be honest. I took an enormous risk, defying Marjorie to get you into that feast. And you thanked me by making a scene with Lord Andros, in front of everybody. Marjorie saw, of course, and she knew exactly how you got there.
I'm sorry about that. I really did try to be discreet.
But you couldn't, could you? Because you're in over your head. I know it. And Marjorie knows it. Which is why it's not safe for me to be around you anymore.
What?
Mira, you're not the girl I knew at Highgarden. She'd never be so reckless. And now that Garibald and I are discussing marriage, I just can't risk being associated with you. Not anymore. You know how much I need this marriage.
That's fine by me. I don't need friends who get so easily overwhelmed.
It makes me sad to hear you talk like that. Was it worth it, at least? Sacrificing so much for your family.
Nothing's worth losing your friendship over, Sarah.
I would have said the same thing once.
Thank you for your help. They'll be very grateful.
I better go before she sees me. She will
Mira Forrester.
Can I help you?
You need to come with me. Now.
Why would I?
Don't make this difficult.
I wish there was an option to make it like a button option. It's like, go quietly or make it difficult.
You still angry at me?
What do you think?
I think I deserve a little gratitude.
He's dead. I shouldn't care how it happened. It doesn't feel like I expected. I thought I'd feel lighter. Or something.
No matter what happens, I'll have your back. Always.
And I yours, little brother. But we should never have come here. This city. It only holds pain for me, Yasha. I was hoping to bury it all with Dezor's corpse.
I can't imagine what it must have been like.
Please, I don't want to talk about it again.
Asher, you're back.
Uncle. Let's collect our second sons and get out of here.
If you did as you were told, Daenerys should deliver.
Daenerys, huh? First names with the Queen now, are we?
I'm not queen yet.
Your Grace, my nephew has returned from his mission.
It seems you played your part in the taking of Meereen, Asher Forrester. Did you run into any trouble? Reports from the battle are muddled. Perhaps you can clear them up.
No battle is without difficulty, Your Grace. But we fulfilled your orders.
All of them? I heard rumors of an incident in the city. Do you know anything about it?
Your Grace, we encountered the slave master, Dezor Zoraza, on the way to the signal tower. I regret that he lost his life.
Oh, don't fucking...
You admit it, then? The punishment for defying a queen is death. And yet you come to me for a reward.
Why should I let this pass?
Don't you dare.
What do you have to say for yourself?
Don't.
I'm waiting.
It was the heat of battle.
A soldier must keep his head in a fight. You disobeyed me. You disappoint me, Forrester. I will not be giving you my second sons.
What?
But, Your Grace, the mission was a success.
What did I tell you? She was never going to help us.
You promised me Croft and his second sons.
And you made me promises you did not keep. A new day is born in Marine. The slaves have thrown off their collars. There must be a few cutthroats who would fight for the likes of you. Now get out.
I'm terribly sorry, Your Grace.
You have nothing to apologize for, Malcolm. I have other plans for you.
Plans for me, Your Grace?
Plans that will help House Forrester, I hope.
I would like you to stay and serve me. I have a task for you.
Your Grace, I am humbled. But I owe my allegiance to my family.
And they will be grateful for the Targaryen alliance you've helped forge.
I am honored you would ask me. Might I discuss it with my nephew first?
Do so. But let me know your answer soon.
You'd seriously consider staying in Essos?
I'm not sure. This is all rather sudden. If she does come to Westeros, we'd want Daenerys Targaryen on our side.
It's true.
And now you've angered her, she may need some convincing. It's worth thinking about, you have to admit.
You're right, Uncle. The Mother of Dragons would make a powerful ally.
If she succeeds in taking the Iron Throne, she'll be the only ally we need. But whatever comes of this, we still need men who will fight for us now. The Queen thought we might find them here, among the newly freed.
The little Queen is right. Marine holds plenty of killers, and I know the worst.
So what are we waiting for? Let's go get them.
I don't know, Asha. They're not like us. To them, killing is a sport. It's fun.
Let them have fun with the White Hills, then. As long as they kill them, I don't care.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Damn straight.
I must talk further with the Queen. Don't get yourselves killed.
So, where exactly are we going?
Well, these fighters used to be slaves. If I had to guess, I'd say they'll be trying to live like masters.
So, drinking and whoring. Ah, Coca-Cola. The greatest of sodas. And if you think Pepsi's better, you're wrong.
You're freezing.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Someone has to keep watch.
It's getting worse, isn't it?
But we're only about a few days out from the Antler River. We cross a bridge the first men built. And from there, we can try to find the North Grove. Right, Sylvie?
We're not going north. We're going south to join Mance and the rest of the Free Folk.
But look, I can't go south. The Night's Watch will have my head.
Better than losing it to a White Walker.
Sylvie, he's come a long way. He knows what he's doing.
Does he now? Tell me then. How did my brother get that gash in his arm? You dressed his wound up well enough. But why'd he get hurt in the first place?
What does that have to do with the...
Hush, Cotter! I'm asking Fishface here.
Sylvie!
Don't Sylvie me.
Some wildlings... Free Folk. Mistook Cotter for a crow.
Can't imagine why.
We tried to reason with them, and
Well, things got out of hand.
Out of hand? From the look of him, he was nearly killed. Point is, you don't belong out here.
Sylvie, I've known Gadded a while now. He may not be one of us, but I trust him.
I've been waiting months for you, Cotter, and when you finally come home, it's with some crow who can barely build a fire. No, we don't need to die for him.
Me neither. Fucking North Grove isn't even real. And if it is, it's probably full of wolves and more wildlings.
You didn't lose your nerve already, did you?
Finn, will you
Just piss off!
Some leader you turned out to be.
There's no winning with him.
You should listen to him. The further north you go, the more likely you'll never come back. It's just not worth it. Once Cotter's fit to travel, we head south. With or without you, Garrod.
Sylvie.
You need to rest. And we'll be wanting something to eat. I won't go far.
Oh, don't be angry, Garrod. This isn't what it looks like. I can explain.
Why'd you even bring me here, Cotter? You said you'd take me to the North Grove.
Sylvie knows these woods better than I do. If anyone can find the North Grove, it's her. And besides, I couldn't just leave her. I won't do that. Not again.
Then convince her to go with us. She's your sister.
Well, maybe she's right. Maybe you don't belong up here.
You don't mean that. So that's it. I can't head north without a guide.
I go where she goes. I'm sorry, Garrod. Garrod.
You and your sister, you don't look much alike. The white hair and...
I know where you're getting at. So you may as well just say it.
I just wondered.
She was born like that. My mother used to call her Little Moon. The rest of our village thought she was a bad omen. The better of them stayed away from her. The worse. Let's just say I'm glad to be rid of them.
Why didn't you just tell me the truth? That you came here to find your sister?
I wanted to, but I didn't think you'd understand. I couldn't risk it. I'm sorry.
Why were they afraid of your sister?
I know I'm doing this so out of order.
Southerners call us wildlings. Same reason you put up that wall to keep us out. People are assholes.
Yeah, they are.
What happened to your village? Did you leave?
Well, not by choice. When Sylvie reached 2 years, they told my mother we weren't welcome anymore. She wasn't welcome. I guess they all hoped she wouldn't survive long enough to get a name. But she's tough, Sylvie. No way she wasn't gonna make it.
Where's your mother now?
I don't know. Still back at the village for all I know. She tried to send my sister away. Wrapped her up in furs and everything like a good mother would. I left that night when I heard.
How's your arm feeling?
Decent, I'd say. Why'd you ask? Oh, you mean this one? Yeah, it's shit.
Ah, come on, I help.
You really won't take me north.
I want to help you, Garrod, I mean it. But I can't leave her behind. And besides, north of here, I'd be as lost as you.
See, I don't hold it against him. I get what he's... You know, I get where he's coming from. I get why he's angry. Well, not angry, but you know what I mean. He's gonna find Finn. Doesn't look like it. Saw Sylvie back here, so let's go find her. Oh, there's Finn.
Wonder if her mother gave her that. Little Moon.
What are you doing over here? There's a perfectly good fire.
I'm not going anywhere near those fucking wildlings.
Oh, come on. Just give them a chance.
I did. And look where it got us.
I'm sorry for getting you into this mess. Really.
Not your fault. I wanted to come. Just didn't know this is how it'd turn out.
Come on, Finn.
You'll freeze your ass off if you stay here.
Suppose you're right. May as well get warm before I die.
See, I think deep down, Finn's a good guy. He's just got a, he's got a temper.
Whoa!
Fucking hell. Could you have been any louder?
Sorry.
Never met a crow before. Sorry I almost killed you. Might have done you a favor, though. Plenty of things want to kill a crow up north. Giants, fens, shadow cats and ice spiders. And the White Walkers, of course. A spear sounds nice after all that, doesn't it?
I'm not a crow anymore. I left that life behind me.
Once a crow, always a crow. That's what they say, anyway. Don't frighten our dinner away. Shit.
Mind if I give it a shot?
Go ahead. You know how to use that? You're not gonna shoot me in the leg, are you?
I may do all right.
Just be sure to keep it aimed that way. Is that what making do means?
Yeah.
Come on.
Ah, you're joking.
Maybe next time, Garrod. Well, since we don't have any food...
It didn't, like, it wasn't registering that I pulled it back. God damn it.
Your dinner. It won't fill you up, but it'll make you think you're not hungry for a while. At least I don't have to worry about you trying to shoot me. You ever lost anyone, Garrod? Someone you really cared about. Someone you thought you couldn't live without seeing ever again. Do you know what that's like?
I lost my family. First my mother, then my sister and father.
So you know how it feels. Carter and I, we lost everything too. And we nearly lost each other. I didn't think he'd make it back this time. And I won't risk losing him again. Not even for the North Grove.
You know something about it, don't you?
Only what I've heard. But don't get your hopes up. It's not worth it.
Please, Sylvie. I need to know.
A few years back, one of the Aish River clans set out to find it. They'd heard stories. That the cold couldn't touch it. That it's safe, even in the dark of winter. So they'd set out, all full of hope. And none of them ever returned.
Maybe they stayed there. Maybe they liked it.
Free folk never stay anywhere. You'd know that if you were...
Garrett! Help!
Cutter!
What the fuck? Look out!
White Walker. It's raining outside. That's weird. Didn't think it'd rain today.
This looks like the place.
This is definitely the place.
So, who are we dealing with exactly?
Pit fighters. Two go in, one comes out. Day
two
after day.
Men enter.
No
one man leaves.
Killed.
Two men
you
enter.
Can survive
one
that is capable.
Mad
of
Max
anything.
For you.
They're crazed savages.
What was the joke?
Pit fighter is worth
Sorry.
Any 10 cell swords.
I'm not trying to talk over their dialogue. God damn it.
And that's not going to be easy. Don't expect to charm them or reason with them.
You were a pit fighter. If they're anything like you, we'll be just fine.
Understand, they are nothing like me. These aren't soldiers.
Son of a bitch.
They're animals you unleash.
What was the joke from Futurama? It was two robots enter, then one robot leaves, then another robot leaves after being declared the winner. I think that was the line. It was when Bender was a ultimate robot fighter.
Seeing the masters overthrown.
They're not gone. They're just on their knees. And when they get back to their feet, they'll be more dangerous than ever.
You did what?
Oh.
What the fuck?
Trust me. You don't want to get involved, Asha.
All right, so they're insane. Kinda like it.
Your friends have been busy.
Let's hope our heads don't end up here.
Fool!
Oh, one last thing. They're not fond of strangers.
Oh, good.
Or anyone who shows weakness. Or fear. Or really any highborn pricks with lily white arses like you, little brother.
I can handle this.
Oh, after you then.
Well, if it isn't Beskar, the fucking basilisk.
We just want to talk to Amaya.
You don't want to be in here, little man. You best go back the way you came before I decide to eat you. I'll start with your eyeballs. Fucking juicy when they pop.
You sure you have room for me? You seem pretty well fed already.
My master only ever fed me when I won. I won a lot. Now, you've got to the count of three to turn around and walk away. One, two, I like this one. Hey, Amaya!
I thought he'd end up liking that. These guys kind of remind me of the Skelligers from The Witcher. You know, they respect strength and guts.
Is that a pit?
Yeah, some masters couldn't get enough of the fighting, so they built their own private pits, where things could get really nasty.
Chance to stand up and fight.
That's Amaya.
Keep your cock in your pants, little brother. She's likely to chop it off.
Well, hello there.
Not many people get past the beast. You must need something very badly. So, out with it.
I've come with an offer. I think it's one that'll interest you and your men.
If you wanted my interest, you wouldn't have shown up with her.
Amaya, please.
Please what? I had a friend once, the Basilisk, but she died a long time ago.
I earned my freedom.
You walked out on me. On all of us. Fighting side by side, we were goddesses of the pits. But when you're born trash, I guess you can't help going back to the gutter.
Leave her alone! I don't care what your history is. Beska's the most loyal friend I've ever had.
So, what is it that you want?
Why shouldn't we rip you to pieces and feed you to the beast?
My patience wears thin.
My enemies mean to butcher my family in Westeros. They killed my father. They killed my little brother. And now I need great warriors to help me avenge their deaths and reclaim my home.
You think we're sellswords? We don't fight other people's wars. We are pit fighters, artists who paint in blood.
That was yesterday. The fighting pits have been closed. You're all free now. Free to do what you want.
Don't you see that?
Yes, we are free. Why would we follow another?
We don't have masters anymore! Why would we follow anyone ever again?
You all excel at combat, but you know nothing until you've tasted the thrill of war. Waves of men crashing together. Blood and steel. In Westeros, they sing of our great warriors for thousands of years.
Amaya. The way I left was terrible, I know. But we were friends once. And could be again. Please, set aside your anger and listen to him.
You want to lead pit fighters? You have to earn their respect first.
We don't know who you are until we see you bleed.
You're gonna have to show them you can fight.
All right. Who?
You?
His name is Bloodsong. He's vicious, fearless, and fast.
Reminds me of,
I've never seen him before. Take a good look there. He's the man who's going to kill your boy.
We'll have to kill him. It'd be a shame to waste such a talented fighter. Perhaps if I just subdued him.
No one has ever subdued him.
First time for everything. He reminds me of... What was it? Was his name the Red Serpent? He was the guy who fought for Tyrion when he had trial by combat against the Mountain.
Your pretty blonde beard. I'd sooner bend you over to fuck than fight you.
Thanks for noticing the beard.
Well, come on! Let's see how you die!
If I die in there.
Yeah? You have a dying wish? This ought to be good.
Will you return to Westeros and kill as many Whitehills as you can?
No. I'll drink enough ale to drown a horse.
Hey! I need those!
You'll fight with the weapons we give you.
Great.
You all see this cockless Westerosi? He's come to order us to battle, like our masters did.
I kill no man because another orders me to. I kill a man
because it pleases me! Let me show you how we dance in Marine.
That's lovely. You know why I kill a man? So he's dead and I'm alive. Let's get this over with.
Choose a weapon and try not to die. Only one of you leaves the pit alive. May the best fighter win.
The best would be me.
Here, use this.
Closer to an axe. I know the name of that weapon, I just can't think of it.
Are you ready, Westerosi? This is gonna hurt! Yours will be a beautiful death! Isn't that something you'd like to say? Hear that, boy? We cannot let the crowd go wanting.
I think I can, actually.
For that, you die slow.
That's no weapon worthy of blood.
See if you're still smiling after I break your face!
Ah, come on. I should have picked the club. Oh, that was cool.
Damn it.
Would it help if I stood still?
Maybe.
Come on, pretty boy. At least try to hit me.
Triangle. Come on, man. They lift him up off the ground. Oh, right in the knee. Jeez. Seems slow. What's the matter? Boom!
People for sport! The masters who once held your chains decided who lived and who died. But as you can see, I'm not here to be your master. I chose you for a reason! You're true warriors! Warriors I admire and respect! You deserve better than this! You deserve more than to die for someone else's entertainment! Fight with me, and you will have glory and gold! If you've got the balls to follow me, we will set sail at dawn, and to those too craven to join me, to hell with you!
Yeah! What the hell is that? Oh, dealing with the White Walker.
I knew them!
What are those things?
Oh, God. Over here! Over here!
Come on, we need fire. So I'm gonna kill it.
Anything can be killed!
That's not necessarily true. Oh! Oh, Finn's dead. Oh, he's...
Finn! Stay with me!
Oh no, he's going down. He's dead. But, yeah, Finn's not... He's not... Oh. Harvest. Oh, come on.
In hell.
Damn it, babe.
Where's Finn?
He was over there!
Told you.
Finn!
Oh, holy
They're
hell.
Everywhere.
We make for the North Grove! But we need to stick together!
I hope you're right about this, Garrett.
Me too.
Ow, me.
All right, guys. As soon as I can, I'm gonna pause and right here. We'll pick up right here next time, guys. Thank you for watching. As always, you know, like I always say, Facebook, Twitter, website down in the description. Like, comment, subscribe. If you enjoyed the video, I always feel like I have something else to say, but I really don't. So, guys, thank you for watching. Tune in next time. I'm AJ Gales, this is the Unthired Gaming Channel. Guys, I'm out.